together in one place. Oh, please, if you want to really achieve for God, let there be fellowship or unity. Don't be divided.
The violent wind
is amazing to note that the fearful, frightened Peter, Peter, who was so frightened, after that event, after the anointing by the Holy, after that heavy baptism of the Holy Spirit, Peter, can you imagine? Can you see the transformation? Peter, on that same day, was able to come out boldly and address the whole crowd because of what is happening. The crowd has gathered and said, look, what is happening? And they gathered. And Peter spoke to them. And the rest of that chapter, chapter 2, tells us about that Peter's sermon. It was sound. It was powerful. It was convincing. It was directed on the Holy Spirit. And Peter, the important thing I wanted to note here, he spoke boldly, not fearfully. He spoke clearly. He spoke with conviction. He spoke with a note of authority. And that day, we had the first fruits of evangelism through the power of the Holy Spirit. 3,000 people in one sermon. 3,000 people responded and came forward to receive Jesus. That was just speaking out through the anointing of the Holy Spirit. In chapter 3 of the same Acts, you see that Peter and John were going to the same temple for prayer. And you remember the story very well, how a lame man who had been a beggar all his life there, against people, coming out and looking for something from Peter and John. This is after Pentecost, the second major event. The first one, 3,000 people came to know the Lord through one sermon. The second was in this situation where the main person was begging for alms. Peter and John looked at him and said, look, silver and gold we don't have, but what we have we shall give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And the Bible tells us that the laborer jumped up and started walking. Okay, if there be something lame in your life, maybe in your business or in your home, something that has been oppressed, something that has been down, something that has been distressed, oh, this morning there will be a quickening in the name of Jesus. You are needing a touch of God this morning. On this Pentecost day, we'll say to you, rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. Amen. Say to your neighbor, anyone around who is needing, today is a day of healing. It can happen right now if you believe. Because Jesus Christ is here, the Holy Spirit is here. If there was somebody here needing physical healing right now, in the name of Jesus,
yeah.
Believe someone that are the rules. I don't know what you are doing, but whatever you are doing, the Lord is saying to you, it will so flourish, and I'll be an impact. Is somebody getting jealous? Oh, look at your head. This is the end. Our preaching of the gospel is not just mere words, it is in power. Because the Holy Spirit has come. Oh, you know, the disciples are being dead. They don't know that they've changed. From frightened people, they now became the rulers. They took over the synagogues. They took over the land. In fact, the authority was there. They were turning the whole world upside down. 12 plus 120. Oh, I pray that we shall so be filled with the Holy Spirit that the impact in the search that St. Matthew will turn Abuja upside down. Go to other parts of that. Well, you know, Paul was really breathing. Paul was a lawyer. Or lawyers, forgive me. You know, lawyers are very, very deep in learning. And they like process. You know, lawyers like due process. So Paul, being a lawyer, went and obtained letters, authority. He was doing the wrong thing, but he collected the people of God. I was going with all the authorities and so on to go to, you know the story very well, there's no time, to Damascus. And a light from heaven shone down and arriving was bright. This arrogant, learned, due processed Jew. And Paul was a very Jew to the glory, if you read his testimony. He was very, very righteous according to the law. Very proud. And there it was. The light showed. Oh, I pray this morning that when you are doing something, but it is something, although you are doing it with zeal, it is wrong. Oh, may the light of God lighten your heart. Something that this is wrong but you can't see. Oh, may the light of God just illuminate your mind. Oh, more than that, you know, a voice called to Paul. He was Saul there. He said to him, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Oh, my dear brother, my dear sister, I pray this morning that when the devil is tempting you, you are doing something the way it's wrong, you are doing it so seriously as if that's the thing. Oh, may the Lord call you by name. Yeah. Call you by name so you can repent. But you know what he's doing so beautifully? The Lord, when he loves you, he calls you by name. Do you know how the Lord calls you? Have you listened to him? Okay, today, how many are ready and willing? When you get back home, the Lord will call you by name. Yeah. I can't see your hands. He's going to call you. Put your hands together for the Lord Jesus. And when he calls you, tonight or sometime today in your quiet place, when he calls you, please listen. Because he will say something that will be a turning point in your life. He will do something that is for the rest of your life, you will gloriously rejoice. He says, so, that was negative. For you, it's going to be positive. The Lord is going to call you in a loving way on this day of Pentecost and speak to you in gracious words. Are you fearful? May you receive this joy. Amen. Oh, are you frightened? May the Lord encourage you. Amen. Are you confused? May the Holy Spirit guide you. Amen. Oh, are people oppressing you? Of intimidations, and you know it can be real even at your levels. In a very simple way, you know, in our villages, small communities that they are, people are very, very oppressive, especially in the occult. There are some of the people down who really do all kinds of things to oppress others. Recently in my own village, the village head was very close to us, not the church, although a Muslim, but was such a wonderful lover of the church. You know, we come to every event that we are doing. He passed on, the and then a new one is to be selected. You know, because of the people involved that wanted this, every single elder in the town didn't want to call the meeting. They were fearful. I don't want to be told I'm the one. And I was in Lagos at that time doing this convocation at the University of Lagos. And they called me and said, we are busy. Don't swear. Choosing a village chief is not very important now. Don't swear. They said, I know. The whole thing becomes so tense now. I said, don't worry, we are coming. My dear brothers, people were afraid just to call a meeting because they feel that the person didn't get it will be after them for the rest of their lives. I called a meeting and I said, oh, look, watch here. We are going to meet, we are going to pray, and we are going to select. And the person we select with this one by God will be the next chief of this village. If you don't like it, whatever you do, your witchcraft cannot touch me because I'm sitting in heavenly places, far above all principalities and powers. And that's why you are. My friend, that's why you are. I said you are seated in the heavenly places. And I mean, far above all principalities and powers and witches and wicked. If you see the kind of thing that Jesus was doing, if you read the Gospels, the kind of thing that Jesus was doing, filled with the Holy Spirit. That's what the Bible says, Luke. If you read particularly chapter 14 and so on, various places. And amazingly in John, the same Jesus says, you will do greater things than I did. Eh? Did you see what the kind of thing that Jesus did? He raised the sick, healed the lepers, healed the lame, he opened the eyes of the blind. Even someone was dead, Lazarus, he raised him from the dead. And Jesus said, you. I said, you, not just me, you, not just our vicar, you. You will do greater things. Oh, you're going to see me. I said, you will do greater things. That is what Jesus is saying, not me. Well, our time is gone, but there are two other. This was a sign of power. We can spend the whole day on this. This sign of power, because the whole of the Acts of the Apostles was the Acts of the Holy Spirit. And the good news is that the Holy Spirit is alive and available. Oh, receive ye the Holy Spirit. Amen. My friend, if you haven't received before, I say, receive ye the Holy Spirit. Amen. It's available. And it's going to empower you. Under the anointing, you'll do exploits for Jesus Christ. Those of you in the choir, you sing even joyfully, more joyfully now, because Holy Spirit is filling you. Amen. Amen. Now the second thing was that there was a fire. The movement was like a fire. And fire speaks of what? Purity. The Holy Spirit is a sanctifier. The Holy Spirit is the one who purifies. Oh, are you here this morning and your life is so messed up? Oh, you've tried, you've done, you've received Jesus, but there's no purity in your life. You're finding it difficult to have a sanctified life. Oh, you're struggling. My dear brother, my dear sister, the struggle is over. Because with the Holy Spirit will purify your heart. Will sanctify your life. He will grant you joy. In fact, he will replace that fear in your heart with such tremendous joy. Because he's the one in you who will bear the fruit. And this morning, oh, I pray that as you go out on this beautiful day, you will bear the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Oh, Galatians 5:21, that is my past. Oh, I love it, I love it, I love it. Because it says the fruit of the Holy Spirit. I know you will say it with me. The fruit of the Holy Spirit is love and joy and peace and patience and kindness and goodness and well, I need to know Galatians 5:22, because that is another impact of the Holy Spirit. From within, he gives you a new beauty, a new character, a new integrity, a new consciousness. You will be transformed from within. Oh, you will be such that people will love you because of your goodness, your kindness, your soul, Christ-like, your character. You don't Spirit indeed transforms you, and there is a bearing of the fruit. Oh, I pray, because you see, that is the most powerful way to preach the gospel. That people see the beauty of Christ in your life. Oh, I pray that the matters, each of us, I pray that Jesus will so reflect in our lives that many people see the beauty of Jesus in your life. I say, as a husband, may Jesus be seen in your life beautifully daily. I say to you with wives, may Jesus Christ be seen in you in a very beautiful way. Your character will be transformed. I say your character will be transformed. And you know, the third is that they spoke in the new tongue for witnessing and for praying. And I pray that many of you, by the grace of God, will receive the gift of speaking in tongues, because it's powerful for preaching. It's powerful for edification and praying. But many of us are afraid of it. It is a gift. Some of you have received. Those who haven't received, you will receive. I said, those of you who haven't received, you will receive. And you know, apart from this, the power. Apart from the fire for purity, apart from the ability to speak so that people will listen to the gospel and hear it clearly, people will pray with conviction and with power. Apart from that, the Holy Spirit also grants us special anointing. Anointing for conquest, anointing for evangelism, anointing for miracles, anointing for so many things. There are so many things that we have done here this morning, but I summarize it in Luke 4. And while Jesus is quoting from Isaiah 61, you remember that second one he read from Isaiah, and he said, now look, this is what the anointing, I'm anointed. Say to yourself, I'm anointed. This morning, I am anointed.
I am anointed.
Are you anointed? Amen. I say you are anointed. And you are going to do exploits in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Because when the anointing comes, when the anointing comes, broken hearts are bound up. He sets the prisoner free. He opens the eyes of the blind. Proclaims good news to the poor. Delivers the oppressed. Proclaims the Lord's favor. And so, I said to you this morning, because of Pentecost, dear friends, without the Holy Spirit, it is impossible to live and witness for Jesus. As our bodies be lifeless, there is no breath, the church without the Holy Spirit is... Therefore, we need the vibrancy. We need the power. We need the grace. We need the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And so, I pray this morning on this Pentecost day, as we conclude, may the Holy Spirit fill you today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit empower you for exploits in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit guide you in all truth. You will never be confused.
Amen.
You will never know which way do I go. The Holy Spirit will guide you.
Amen.
May you receive divine wisdom to excel.
Amen.
If you are working in the civil service, you are working in business, wherever you are, may you revive, may you obtain this morning, receive divine wisdom to excel.
Amen.
You will excel.
Amen.
I say you will excel.
Amen.
May you be so empowered that you will perform miracles. You pray for people, they will see results. I'm telling you this morning, if you believe on this Pentecost day, receive it. From today, you are empowered. Because when you pray, God will answer.
Amen.
He will answer in a marvelous way.
Amen.
Oh, you shall do exploits.
Amen.
St. Matthew, you shall do exploits.
Amen.
I say you shall do exploits.
Amen.
If you believe, you shall tell it well.
Amen.
And now for those who are under oppression of any kind, oh, if you are here oppressed by any false sense, then we say to them, any evil altar, any demonic attack, any oppressive spirit, we say the anointing breaks every yoke today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The name of Jesus has set you. you touch anyone, they'll be blessed. When you talk to anybody, they'll be blessed. When they are dry, they'll be watered. When they are broke, they'll be enriched. When they are not moving, the Lord will. You're touched to somebody, you're being a favor to somebody, you're being a friend to somebody. From today, you become something different. Because Jesus Christ has come to you in a wonderful way. And I know that He's here. He's here this morning. And if there's anyone who indeed, as we sit, would individually, because this is not, I'm not talking about your receiving the Lord Jesus Christ, yes, you received Him. It's a day of empowerment. It's a day of glory. It's a day that you'll be endued with power. You shall receive power. If there be any here this morning who want to receive power in the Holy Spirit, may you rise as we pray. If there be anyone who want to receive power in the Holy Spirit, may you rise as we sing. Because we know the Lord is here. Oh. Ah, hallelujah. May the Spirit of the Lord come now.
Jesus' name.